particle physics, we already discussed about alpha decay and beta decay. Now, the third mode of decay is gamma decay. Let us start the topic gamma decay.
Gamma decay. The gamma rays emission is also a decay process. In gamma decay process, a nucleus which is at large or high energy state will come to ground state by the emission of gamma rays. Gamma rays are nothing but the photon. So gamma emission is a photon emission. So normally gamma emission is a continuation of alpha decay and beta decay. After alpha and beta decays, if the nucleus are in higher energy state, so in order to attain its stability, it have to emit its extra energy. So the extra energy is coming out from the nucleus in the form of gamma rays. So this process is known as gamma decay. So after gamma emission, initial nucleus at higher energy level is returns back to its to final position, that is most stable position, by the emission of a gamma ray or more gamma rays. Okay, so a photon carries away not only the net energy but also the net angular moment. So in order to conserve, when an initial nucleus is coming, okay, if the initial nucleus which is at the higher energy level or which it may be unstable due to high energy is attain stability, that is it will come to the final nucleus state, the same nucleus in initial state and in the final state nucleus are the same, but they differ only in their energies. So the extra energy is emitted in the form of gamma rays. So the initial nucleus is changes into the final nucleus, even though their nuclear structure is same. If the initial and final nucleus contain same number of nucleons, their energy will be different. So this energy difference is given to the gamma rays, not only the difference in energy but also according to law of conservation of angular momentum, the initial angular momentum will be equal to the angular momentum of the gamma ray and the final nucleus, or the difference of the initial and final states is carried out by gamma ray. Not only that, the difference in the angular momentum is also carried away by this photon. So the angular momentum of the photon is the difference of this. It is the magnitude of its angular momentum, maybe ji plus jf, its magnitude. It will always less than or equal to ji plus jf, or it is greater than or equal to ji minus jf, its magnitude. Okay, the angular momentum of the photon is in between these two, or it is equal to these two. Okay, energetics of gamma decay. Consider a nucleus of mass m at rest. It decays from its initial energy state to final energy state ef. So this is the energy is equation. So Ei is equal to Ef plus the energy of the gamma ray plus this. This is the plus E gamma. So this is the, we can neglect the rest mass energy of the photon. So the initial energy of the, so this is the rest mass energy of the initial nucleus is equal to the rest mass energy of the final nucleus plus the kinetic energy of the recoiling nucleus So here, what is TR? It is the kinetic energy of the nucleus, that is given by P square by kinetic energy is equal to P square by 2m. Here this is the recoiling nuclear, its momentum is PR, so it is PR square by 2m. So we can write EA is equal to EF plus E gamma plus TR. We know that so when we write the equation for the momentum, its initial, the nucleus is at rest, so its initial momentum is zero, and the final momentum is the momentum of the recoil nucleus plus the momentum of the gamma ray. So we can write PR is equal to P gamma, and they are opposite to each other in order to conserve the momentum. Okay, they have to move in opposite side. So the nuclear recoil with a momentum equal at opposite to the gamma ray. So the delta E is the difference in the initial. So delta E is the difference in the energy between initial nucleus and final nucleus. So the in the case of relativistic equation, E gamma is the energy of the gamma ray is given by C into P, because the photon is moving with velocity of light. So C plus P gamma is the momentum of the gamma ray. So this delta E, so this when we write this equation for TR, what is TR? TR is equal to PR square by 2m. Here, okay, something is missing. Okay, I will tell you. TR is equal to PR square by 2m. That is equal to, we know that PR is equal to P gamma. So this is P gamma square by 2m. So when you substitute for P gamma as E gamma divided by C, you will get this as E gamma square by 2m C square. So you will get the expression TR square is equal to E gamma square by 2m C square. So this delta E is equal to E gamma plus E gamma plus TR, where TR is the kinetic energy of the recoil nucleus. Let us substitute for TR here. That is TR is equal to E gamma square divided by 2m C square. Then you will get the expression as delta E is equal to E gamma plus E gamma square divided by 2m C square. So when you find out the solution for this equation, this is a second order differential equation. So its solution minus P plus or minus square root of P square. So when we do like that, you will get E gamma is equal to m c square into minus 1 plus or minus square root of 1 plus 2 into delta E divided by m c square, all raised to 1 by 2. So we get an expression. So this is the expression for E gamma. So the energy difference delta E is typically in the order of MeV, while the rest mass energy m c square are in the order of A into 10 raised to 3 MeV. So we know that delta E is very, very small compared to the mc square. So we take only first two terms of this expression. So we can neglect the higher term. So E gamma is equal to delta E minus delta E square divided by 2 mc square. This is known as the recoil correction. For lower energy gamma ray, this recoil energy is less than 1 MeV. And for higher energy gamma rays, that is around, if the gamma ray energy is in the order of 5 to 10 MeV, it gives a recoil energy in the range 100 EV. So, it is very, very low. So, we can neglect this recoil correction. So we can write E gamma is equal to delta E. So this is considered only in the case of most bar effect. Okay. So the normal cases, this E gamma is equal to delta E. So the difference in energy difference between the initial and final nucleus is taken away by the gamma ray. So, the energy of gamma ray is equal to the rest mass energy difference between the initial and the final nucleus. Or it is the energy difference between the initial nucleus and the final nucleus. So gamma ray is nothing but electromagnetic radiation. So electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. So these fields are produced due to distribution of charges and currents. So the charge distribution will give you the electric field, and the current varying current will give you the magnetic field. So we can analyze the gamma radiations in terms of electric field and magnetic field. So the static distribution of charges and current gives a static electric and magnetic field. This field can analyze in terms of multipole moments of charge distribution. So the multipoles includes dipole moment, quadrupole moment, octupole moment, etc. If the charge distribution or the current distribution is varying with time, the radiation field is produced. So the static dipole, that is a positive charge and negative charge which are placed at a distance of set, produce a dipole moment. Usually we notate the dipole moment in terms of P, but in here in this crane it is represented by D. D is equal to P into Z. D is equal to Q into Z, where Q is charge and Z is the distance between these charges. A static magnetic dipole can produce. We know that a dipole moment, magnetic dipole moment produced by the current carrying loop, mu is equal to I into A. There is no magnetic monopole exist, so its part is zero. Even though there is an electric monopole, it will not contribute to this part because that type of transition is prohibited. We already studied that this varying electric dipoles and magnetic dipoles, or higher, this produces a magnetic electromagnetic radiation. In dipole moments or quadrupole moments or higher multipole moments, normally we call that as a multipole moments, higher moments, that means quadrupole moment, octupole moment, is generally we call that as a multipole moments. So these multipole moments are electromagnetic radiation producing in the reason. I mean responsible, they are responsible for the production of electromagnetic radiation. So charges, equivalent opposite charge oscillate cheyina samayathu, for example, we can allow a charges to oscillate along the z-axis. So we get this dt, that is a dipole moment producing. E dipole moment can be represented by qz into cos omega t. Moments are ivada dipole moments produces a dipole radiation field. Similarly, magnetic dipole produces a magnetic dipole radiation field. Here ee magnetic dipoles ennu parayunnathu current carrying loops aanu. Ivada nammal consider cheynathu ee varying current carrying loop endeyunu ഒരു മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഡൈപോൾ ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്നു. ദാറ്റ് മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഡൈപോൾ മ്യൂ ഓഫ് ടി ഇസ് ഇക്വൽ ടു ഐ എ ഇൻടു കോസ് തീറ്റ. ഐ ഈസ് ദ കറന്റ് എൻഡ്, എ ഈസ് ദ ഏരിയ ഓഫ് ക്രോസ് സെക്ഷൻ. ഓക്കെ, സോ ദിസ് ഐ എ കോസ് തീറ്റ എന്ന് പറയുന്ന മാഗ്നറ്റിക് മൊമെന്റ് വിൽ പ്രൊഡ്യൂസ് എ മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഡൈപോൾ റേഡിയേഷൻ. സോ ദിസ് മൾട്ടിപോൾസ് ആർ റെസ്പോൺസിബിൾ ഫോർ പ്രൊഡ്യൂസിംഗ് ദ ഇലക്ട്രോ മാഗ്നറ്റിക് റേഡിയേഷൻസ്, ഓർ സിംപ്ലി they are responsible for the production of gamma rays. Now we are going to discuss about the characteristics of dipole radiation. Dipole mathram eduthu dipole radiation de characteristics parayum, pinne adu multiple pole la varumbo engine undu nu generalize cheyyum. That we are going to do. Okay, so now we discuss about the important characteristics of dipole radiations. The power radiated into a small element of area in the direction at an angle theta with respect to z-axis varies as sine square theta. So, the power ഉണ്ടാവുക എന്നുള്ളത് പ്രപ്പോർഷണൽ ടു സൈൻ സ്ക്വയർ തീറ്റ ടേമിനോട് പ്രപ്പോർഷനിലായിരിക്കും. വി ടേക്ക് സെഡ് ആക്സിസ് ആസ് എ റെഫറൻസ് ആക്സിസ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ നമ്മൾ എപ്പോഴും പറയുക ആ പവർ റേഡിയേഷൻസ് വിത്ത് റെസ്പെക്ട് ടു സെഡ് ആക്സിസ് ദാറ്റ് വിൽ, സോ വെൻ വി ടേക്ക് എൻ ഏരിയ ആൻഡ് ദ പവർ റേഡിയേറ്റഡ് ഇൻ ടു ദാറ്റ് സ്മോൾ ഏരിയ വിച്ച് ഈസ് അറ്റ് എൻ ആംഗിൾ വിച്ച് ഈസ് ദാറ്റ് ഏരിയ ഈസ് at an angle theta with the z axis. So avade undavuna power radiate power radiation is proportional to sin square theta ki proportional aayirikkum. So this is known as the angular distribution. So idin nammal endha paraya angular distribution. Dipole angular distribution is varies as sin square theta. But higher orders, when we take higher order multipoles, if for example the quadrupole radiation, octupole radiation, adinte angular distribution will be different. So nammal ingane angular distribution measure cheyyunnathu kaaranam we can determine which type of multipole is present in the radiation. Adhaayid ee multipole ivide present oru ee decay process il undaavuna ede type radiation aanu emit cheyyunnathu ennulladinte measurement, this ede type of radiation aanu പ്രസന്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നത് എന്നുള്ളത് ഈ ആംഗുലർ ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ കണ്ടു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ അറിയാൻ പറ്റും. ദേർ ആർ ഡിഫറെന്റ് ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് റേഡിയേഷൻ. സോ വി ഡിസ്കസ് ദാറ്റ് ദ ഇലക്ട്രോമാഗ്നറ്റിക് റേഡിയേഷൻസ് കംസ് വെൻ ദർ ഈസ് എൻ ഓസിലേറ്റിംഗ് ചാർജസ് ആൻഡ് കറന്റ്സ് വിച്ച് ആർ ചേഞ്ചിങ് വിത്ത് ടൈം. സോ ദ ചാർജ് ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ ഈസ് കോൾഡ് മൾട്ടിപ്പോൾ ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് മൾട്ടിപ്പോൾ മോണോപോൾ ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ, ഡൈപോൾ ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ, കോൺട്രോപോൾ ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ എക്സെട്ര. എ പ്യുവർ മോണോപോൾ ഡിസ്ട്രിബ്യൂഷൻ ഈസ് പെർഫെക്ട്ലി സിമെട്രിക്. മോണോപോൾ, ദ മോണോപോൾ മൊമെന്റ് ഈസ് എൻ സ്കേലർ ക്വാണ്ടിറ്റി, ബട്ട് ഡൈപോൾ മൊമെന്റ് ഈസ് എ വെക്ടർ ക്വാണ്ടിറ്റി ദാറ്റ് വി നോ. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് മോണോപോൾ മൊമെന്റ് മീൻസ് ദ ടോട്ടൽ ചാർജ്. That is mean by monopole moment. Okay, dipole moment is a vector quantity. We know that quadrupole moment is a tensor quantity. Like that. So the electric field of this distribution has a characteristic angular distribution. So the electric field of this distribution, that is the monopole distribution, dipole distribution, quadrupole distribution, if dipole moment moment oscillate, that can generate a radiation which is termed as the electric dipole radiation in time. So when the magnetic dipole oscillate, it will produce a magnetic dipole radiation. Similarly, magnetic quadrupole radiation, etc. So the gamma photon which is coming out from the nucleus is an electromagnetic radiation, and they are classified like electric dipole radiation, magnetic dipole radiation, and so on. Also the electric monopole will does not give any radiation because it is perfectly symmetric. Its angular function is, the angular distribution is perfectly symmetric. Its angular distribution is spherically symmetric. So the monopole moment will not give any, electric monopole moment will not give any radiation. So now we normally give the value L for indicating which type of radiation is present in the gamma decay. For dipoles we put L is equal to 1. For quadrupole, we put L is equal to 2 and octupole. So, if the radiation is an electric dipole radiation, we call that, we classify that radiation like even radiation means electric dipole radiation. E2 means electric quadrupole radiation, or E3 electric octupole radiation, like that. That is the naming of the radiation which is coming out from the gamma decay. And if there is the radiation is a magnetic dipole radiation, we name it as M1 radiation. If it is magnetic quadrupole radiation, we name it as M2 and M3, like that. So normally this radiations, the radiation coming from the nucleus, that is the gamma decay radiations, are classified as EL radiation or ML radiation. So EL represent electric type of radiation. ML means magnetic type of radiation, and L will decide whether it is a dipole, electric dipole, it is, or electric quadrupole, etc. Or ML represent magnetic dipole, magnetic quadrupole, etc. Generally, we call that radiations as EL and ML radiations. So the second characteristics of the dipole radiations are, so electric and magnetic dipole field have opposite parity. That is, electric dipole have an odd parity, and a magnetic dipole have an even parity. So both have different parities. So that is the second characteristic of dipole radiation. Next, we will generalize into multipole radiation. Okay. So the magnetic field produced by the electric dipole radiation can be represented as B of R is equal to minus B of minus R, and the magnetic field is given by, magnetic multipole radiation is given by B of R is equal to B of minus R. That is, they are of opposite parity. This electric have odd parity and magnetic have even parity. Electric dipole radiation have odd parity while the magnetic dipole radiation have even parity. So third characteristics of dipole radiation, not electric or magnetic dipole radiation, is that the average power radiated is given by P is equal to 1 by 12 pi epsilon 0 omega raised to 4 by C cube d square, where d is the electric dipole. And for magnetic dipoles, P is equal to 1 by 12 pi epsilon 0 omega raised to 4 by C raised to 5 into mu square, where mu is the magnetic dipole moment. Here D is the electric dipole moment and mu is the magnetic dipole moment, and the average power radiated, the equation for average power radiated is this. So these are the characteristics of dipole radiation. Now we apply or generalize this for multiple radiation. These are based upon the classical theory of electromagnetic waves. So these are classical approach. Next we have to discuss about the quantum mechanical approach also. We higher level ikkinu ponda just nammal surface il ninnu maatre parayunnullo, then we will go to the selection rules. Okay, the gamma ray selection rules. Okay, so when we generalize the characteristics into multipole radiations, so let us discuss the important characteristics of multipole radiation or generalized radiation field. So first characteristics, the angular distribution of 2:L pole radiation relative to properly chosen direction is governed by Legendre polynomial. So this is an application for the Legendre polynomial also. So the angular distribution of 2:L pole radiation is governed by the Legendre polynomial. We discussed it in the case of a dipole radiation. So here, for a generalized radiation, for any multiple radiation, this angular distribution of 2:L, where L indicate, if L is equal to 1, 2:1, it is dipole radiation. If L is equal to 2, it is 2:4, quadrupole radiation, like that. So this is a general expression for angular distribution, general expression for angular distribution of any 2:L pole radiation is governed by Legendre polynomial, that is 2PL cos theta. In the case of a dipole, it is equal to P2 is equal to 1 by 2 into 3 cos square theta minus 1. And for quadrupole, it is equal to P4, that is 1 by 8, 35 cos 3 to 4 theta minus 30 cos square theta plus 3. So this is coming from the expansion of legendary polynomial. When you substitute properly for the legendary polynomial, you will get the expression for the angular distribution. Okay. And so next one is the parity of the radiation field. That is, pi ml is given by minus 1 raised to l plus 1. That the parity of ml radiation, if l is equal to 1, it will not exist because no monopole radiation. If l is equal to 2, it is magnetic parity of magnetic dipole radiation. It is given by minus 1 volt l plus 1. L is equal to 1, it is 1 plus 1, 2. So it have an even parity. This we already discussed in the case of a dipole radiation. When we put l is equal to 3, it parity will be negative. So 2 plus 1, 3 minus 1. So parity will be, but there is a parity change. So change in parity. So the parity of radiation field is governed by the situation. Okay. Then for electric field, the parity is given by pi el, electric radiation. This pi el is given by minus 1 raised to l. So the electric multiple radiation have a odd parity. So notice the electric and magnetic multiple have same of same order, always have opposite parity. Okay, it is very, very important. Electric and magnetic multipole of same order always have opposite parity. If both are dipole, magnetic dipole and electric dipole, they are of opposite parity. So quadrupole, in that case also they have opposite parity. Okay, because of this equation. So that about the second property. Expression for radiation power is given by P of sigma V. For electric, sigma is equal to E for electric transition and sigma is equal to M for magnetic transition. So this power radiated is given by 2 into L plus 1 into C divided by epsilon 0 L into 2 L plus 1 double factorial whole square into omega by C all this to 2 L plus 1 into M sigma L the whole square. So this is the expression for power radiated in the case of electric or magnetic dipole radiations. So these are the general characteristics of multifold radiation from the classical point of view. Now in quantum mechanical approach like movable change and varian in the channel, source of the electromagnetic radiation moments are one, multipole moments are one. Away multipole moments in the operator which replace a quantum mechanical approach. So to carry the classical theory into quantum domain, okay, we have to quantize the source of radiation field. So here we replace the multipole moments by appropriate multipole operator. Suppose the initial state is psi I and final state is psi f. So this operator will change the state of the nucleus from psi f to psi i, sorry, psi i to psi f. So the decay probability is governed by the matrix element of the multipole operator, that mfi sigma l. Sigma stands for electric or magnetic, l stands for whether it is dipole, quadrupole, etc. So that is given by integral psi f star m sigma l psi i dv, where this m sigma l is known as the multipole operator. So this integration is carried out over the volume of the nucleus. Here we are not discussing more about the form of the operator mfi. I mean the formula is not bothered about it. So we are going to study about the function. By saying that it will change the nucleus from its initial state to final state, and this operator will also produce a photon with proper parity and energy and multiple order. Operator will change the nucleus from its initial state to final state. And also it will produce a photon having proper energy, parity and multiple order. And now we are going to find out the decay constant or the probability per unit time for this probability for unit time for the production of photon. So this decay constant is given by lambda sigma l is equal to p sigma l divided h by h cut omega. This p sigma l is the energy radiated per unit time. So that is represented by this equation. So this is the equation. Here we are going to replace this term. Okay. So this is radiation power. So in order to get a decay constant, we have to divide this by h cut omega. Okay. So we will get an expression for decay constant. And we replace this term by this metric term, that is this what we call this multiple operator. Okay. Or we replace this by MFI or a sigma value that we already studied. So the decay probability lambda sigma l is equal to p sigma l divided by h cut omega, that is given by 2 into l plus 1 divided by epsilon 0 h cut l 2 l plus 1 double factorial the whole square into omega by c whole raised to 2 l plus 1 mfi sigma l the whole square. So in order to make the calculation simple, we take a single photon transition. So the operator function, in that case the operator function is to change the shell model of a nucleus from one state to another state, from initial state to final state. So when we calculate these terms, we can find out that this include a term which is given by E r is to L y L m theta and phi. So that is the main term included in this operator. So that is given by for E r is to L. This is for electric transition. So this is for in electromagnetic transition. This is, when we take the electric transition, this operator containing a term E r is to L y L m theta phi. This E r is to L, for L is equal to 1, for dipole this is equal to E z, and this term is equal to E 3 z square minus r square for L is equal to 2. So for L is equal to 1, this is in terms of E into, E means charge into the distance unit. So for this is square, these two terms are in terms of length square, so L is equal to 3. For quadrupole, this is equal to E 3 z square minus r square for quadrupole radiation. Okay. And the radial part of transition probability is given by integral 0 to r square r is to L dr divided by integral 0 to r square dr. So the nuclear wave function is a constant, that is psi I. The nuclear wave functions of, that is psi I and psi f, psi f are constant up to the nuclear radius r, and for when r is greater than the nuclear radius r, when the small r is greater than nuclear radius r, its value is zero, or the wave function vanishes for r greater than equal to this. When the r is greater than equal to this capital R, the nuclear wave function vanishes. So the radial part of transition probability, we are integrating from 0 to r, that is r square r is to L dr divided by integral 0 to r square dr. You will get the term as 3 by L plus 3 into r is to L. So when you substitute for this in the above equation, lambda El is given by 8 pi L plus 1 divided by L into 2 L plus 1 double factorial E square divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 h cut into E by h cut c 2 L plus 1 into 3 by L plus 3 the whole square into C R raised to 2L. So lambda L is equal to 8 pi L plus 1 divided by L into 2L plus 1 double factorial E square divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 H cut C E by H cut C into 2L plus 1 into 3 by L plus 3 the whole square into C 2 raised to L. So you will get this expression. So I have one thing to discuss those in this slide here. Here this is E z as the total value of this, that is E r raised to L y L m theta phi, its value is equal to E z for L is equal to 1 dipole, and its value is equal to E into 3 z square r square for L is equal to theta, L is equal to 2 quadrupole radiation. Okay. For magnetic transition, this radial part of transition probability is given by 3 r raised to L minus 1 divided by L plus 1. And this is given by lambda ml is equal to 8 pi L plus 1 divided by L into 2 L plus 1 double factorial the whole square into mu p minus 1 by L plus 1 whole square h cut by mpc the whole square into e square divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 h cut c e divided by h cut c r raised to 2 l plus 1 into 3 by l plus 2 the whole square into c r raised to 2 l minus 1. So actually this is not the exact equation. ഇതൊരു കുറച്ച് മാച്ചിങ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു ഇക്വേഷൻ ആണെന്ന് മാത്രമേ ഇത് എക്സാക്ട്ലി കറക്റ്റ് ആണെന്നൊന്നും ഇല്ല ബിക്കോസ് അത് ആദ്യമായിട്ട് ഫോർമുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത ഒരു ഇക്വേഷൻ ഫോർ ദിസ് റേഡിയേഷൻ ദർ ഇസ് ഓൾസോ സം എക്സെപ്ഷൻസ് അത് അതുമാത്രം അക്യുറേറ്റ് കറക്റ്റ് ഒന്നും അല്ല ഏകദേശം ഒരു ട്രാൻസിഷൻ പ്രോബബിലിറ്റിയുടെ ഇക്വേഷൻ ആണ് ഇലക്ട്രിക് അതിൻ്റെ ആണെങ്കിലും മൾട്ടിപ്പോളിൻ്റെ ആണെങ്കിലും അത് കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് എക്സാക്ട്ലി കറക്റ്റ് ആണെന്ന് നമുക്ക് പറയാൻ പറ്റില്ല ഇക്വേഷൻസ് സോ റിസർച്ച് നൗ ഓൾസോ ഗോയിങ് ഓൺ ഓക്കെ ലാംഡ ഇൻറ്റു എം വൺ അപ്പോൾ നമ്മൾ ട്രാൻസിഷൻ പ്രോബിലിറ്റി എം വൺ ഫോർ മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഡൈപോൾ റേഡിയേഷൻ മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ക്വാഡ്രപോൾ റേഡിയേഷൻ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ അങ്ങനെ നമ്മൾ നോക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് എന്താ ചെയ്യാം എൻ്റെ ട്രാൻസിഷൻ പ്രോബിലിറ്റി വാല്യൂ നോക്കിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഇതാണ് എൻ്റെ വേരിയേഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് അപ്പോൾ ഹയർ മൾട്ടിപോൾസിന് ട്രാൻസിഷൻ പ്രോബിലിറ്റി ഇസ് വെരി വെരി സ്മോൾ ഓക്കെ അതാണ് നമുക്ക് ഇതിൻ്റെ മെയിൻ ആയിട്ടുള്ള റിസൾട്ട് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് നമ്മൾ ഫോക്കസ് ചെയ്ത റിസൾട്ട് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ വെൻ വി ഗോ ഫോർ ഹയർ ടേംസ് ഇറ്റ്സ് മാഗ്നറ്റിക് പ്രോബിലിറ്റി ഡിക്രീസ് സിമിലർലി ഇൻ ഇലക്ട്രിക്കൽ കേസസ് ഓൾസോ വെൻ ദിസ് ഈസ് ഇലക്ട്രിക് ഡൈപോൾ റേഡിയേഷൻ ഇലക്ട്രിക് ക്വാഡ്രപോൾ റേഡിയേഷൻ ഇലക്ട്രിക് ഒക്ടോപോൾ റേഡിയേഷൻ സോ വെൻ വി കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ദ ട്രാൻസിഷൻ പ്രോബിലിറ്റി ഫോർ ഹയർ ഓർഡേഴ്സ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഡിക്രീസസ് ഓക്കെ സോ ലോവർ ഓർഡർ ഇലക്ട്രിക്കൽ ആൻഡ് മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ട്രാൻസിഷൻ പ്രോബിലിറ്റീസ് ട്രാൻസിഷൻസ് ആർ മോർ പോസിബിൾ ഓക്കെ ഇലക്ട്രിക് ട്രാൻസിഷൻ ആണെങ്കിലും മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ട്രാൻസിഷൻസ് ആണെങ്കിലും അത് ചെറിയ ഓർഡർ ആണ് ട്രാൻസിഷൻ ആർ ലോവർ ഓർഡർ ട്രാൻസിഷൻ ആർ മോർ പോപ്പുലർ ദാൻ ഹയർ ഓർഡർ ട്രാൻസിഷൻസ് സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ റിസൾട്ട് ഫ്രം ദിസ് അപ്രോച്ച് ഓക്കെ താങ്ക് യു
ഓക്കെ ഡിയർ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് സോ വാട്ട് ഈസ് എ ഗാമ ഡി കെ ഗാമ ഡി കെ ഇസ് നത്തിങ് ബട്ട് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് എ ഡി കെ പ്രോസസ് ഇൻ വിച്ച് nucleus attains stability by the emission of gamma particle. So what is a gamma particle? It is nothing but the electromagnetic radiation or the emission of photon. So even if a nucleus is unstable after emission of beta particle and alpha particle due to excess of energy, it emit gamma particle in order to attain stability. And the main difference between alpha, beta and gamma decay is that in alpha and beta decay there will be a change in atomic number and mass number of the initial nucleus and the final nucleus. But in the case of gamma decay there is no change in atomic number and mass number of the initial nucleus and the final nucleus. So that about gamma decay.